Commander Tura headquarters in Berlin, the Cold War reaches a new crisis. The Russians haul down the red flag, signifying Soviet withdrawal from the four-power command that has governed Berlin since the war's end. Taking no pains to disguise the fact that they want the Western Allies out of Berlin, the Reds begin a blockade of the city. Tracks are removed from the roadbeds, and trains are stopped for so-called technical reasons. Barges carrying food and coal find the waterways suddenly closed to them. Highways are blocked and deserted. The aim of the Russians to starve the entire city into submission backfires completely. In the shadow of the Soviet sector, 300,000 Berliners gather in protest and pledge support to the Western Allies. Meanwhile, Anthony Eden arrives in the German capital for an emergency meeting, as does the French military commander, General Koenig. Later, America's General Lucius D. Clay, speaking for the Western Allies, announces their decision.
We have a right to be in Berlin, and we intend to maintain that right.
But how, ask freedom-loving people the world over and anxiously await the answer. Can this be true, or is it just an alluring hot weather mirage to lead us on? To answer the question, I'm told this is Atlantic City's competition. Corrupt the drone.
Attention, please. All personnel of the 19th Troop Carrier Squadron report to 19th Operations immediately.
Now what? Somebody forgot to clean the carburetor. We all got to stand in a corner.
Sounds like a hop to Australia to me.
Don't say that. I got a date in an hour.
What's the name? I'll keep it for you. I'm good at that sort of thing.
Who isn't?
Beauties. Who will gather in September to vie for the Miss America crown? In which capacity the winner...
And as soon as ready, proceed to Fairfield, Sassoon, California. At ease. Then to Westover Field, Chicopee Falls, Massachusetts. The said mission will be for the purpose of operational training and will be for a period of 45 days.
Yeah, I've heard that song before. Yeah, 45 days. My wife.
Pardon me, Major. My name is Kowalski. I'm a GCA operator.
Yes?
I was wondering, sir, if I could be replaced on this mission.
Why?
Well, sir, if we're going where I think we're going, I wouldn't do a very good job.
What have you got against Westover Field?
Nothing, sir, but I got an awful lot against Germany, and I got a hunch that's where we're headed for.
The Air Force isn't run on hunches, Sergeant. That's why we put lights on runways. Have a good trip.
Yes, sir.
Police line.
Why don't you put both of them on?
Why don't you jokers stop kidding yourselves? You're going to Germany. That's where you're going.
General Kowalski, we're going to a girl like the Major said.
Didn't you guys see the newsreel just now? The Russians blockaded Berlin. It happened 2 weeks ago. Don't you read the newspapers? They're flying stuff in on C-47s, but they don't carry enough, the papers say. Well, C-54s are bigger and they carry more, and you're the guys that are going to carry.
Hey, Charlie, where do you think we're going?
Not we, just you boys. They don't need any ground grippers like me on this trip.
Well, did you hear anything special?
No, but I just put 1,500 pounds of coffee aboard there, and I haven't heard of any coffee shortage in Massachusetts lately. Yes, sir. Y'all are on your way to feed the crowds. You fly boys get all the breaks. While y'all are up there enjoying yourself flying night and day, just think of me down here in Honolulu. Out on that stinking Waikiki beach, just bathing and sunning myself all day, sipping Tom Collins all night. I can't stand the thought of it. But I'll try, boys. Auf Wiedersehen, y'all.
There goes Diamond Head. Take a good look, fellas, and don't forget it.
Down there someplace is a gal from Scranton who thought she was going dancing with me tonight.
Down there someplace is a boat that'll dock in the morning. My wife and two kids in it. I haven't seen her for 6 months.
Well, the major said it'd only be 45 days.
That's what they said when they sent me to the Philippines in 41.
Hey, fellas, hold it! I was just listening to Winchell. Kowalski's right. We're going to Berlin.
Oh. Berlin!
Wow! Oh, Winchell says they're bringing 50 forts from Alaska, Tokyo, Cali, Panama, Puerto Rico, Honolulu, Alabama, Florida, Mitchell.
Oh! Oh, oh boy, how you?
Hey, Kowalski, who do you like in the 7th Hollywood Park?
Oh, Stuart is. Send back the flight clerk to make up me boy.
Right away. And if it gets cold back here during the night, don't call me. I'll be asleep. Good night.
Good night.
West of your station, cruising 3,500 feet. Request landing instructions. Over.
Ryan, main tower to 7223. Who are you and where are you from? Over.
This is Air Force 7223, 19th Troop Carrier Squadron, Hickam Field, Honolulu.
Ryan, main tower to 7223. Stand by for further instructions. Over.
Roger. 7223, standing by.
Air Force 6421 to Ryan, main tower. Over.
Ryan, main tower to 6421. Where are you from? Over.
Ryan, main tower from 6421. We're from 54th Troop Carrier Squadron from Alaska. Over.
Ryan, main tower. This is Air Force 9922. Over. Where are we from? Well, we're the 20th from Ramey, Puerto Rico. Over.
Boy, this place sure caught it, didn't it?
Not enough. Where they should have used the A-bomb.
Ryan, main tower to 7223. Make a right turn at end of runway. You'll find some of your squadron in parking area. Park there.
Are you fellas cold?
Shut up.
I told you to take warm clothes. Y'all ain't going to Germany. It just don't make good sense. Well, honey child, you all is here. And before you're through, you all's going to wish you never left the old plantation.
Oh, hey, fellas. All right, wait in the building. Someone will come along and show you where your bullets are.
Hey, how about pulling up to a dry spot?
Man, this is a dry spot. You see the rest of the base. It's up to your elbow here. They wait after you be here a while, you'll come right to the same spot here on your day off and walk around because it's so dry.
Yeah, we'll go.
Moving up there, I'm thinking. Quit kicking that mud on me, will you? Come on, quit your slack.
Say, this has got more class than the Savoy.
Hey, get out of here!
Blankenship.
Ho!
Joe!
Here!
Kenneth!
Joe!
Mace!
Ho!
Matteo!
Here!
McCullough!
Close!
Schultz!
Ho!
Kowalski!
Yeah.
You men line up over here.
What?
Not my fault. I didn't make these orders. I just work here.
Give us some time to shave, will you?
This next group over to my right. Barr.
Yeah.
Dornbush.
Yeah,
yeah. Perry. Norris.
Yeah.
Reynolds.
Yeah, that's
me. Simmons. The maintenance you brought's been unloaded. You men set up your supply depot. I'll show you where. You engineers report to your planes immediately.
Now, wait a minute. You called me with the rest of the engineers. I'm Kowalski, GCA.
Yeah, you're down for Berlin.
Berlin?
Temple up. Catch a ride on any plane.
The cesspool ain't bad enough. I gotta fall right in the middle of it. Berlin, yet.
Hey, what are you, wise guy? Can't you take a joke?
Yeah, that's where we pick up the heading of 55 degrees.
Sure glad they sent you along, Lieutenant. I'd be up in Sweden by now.
I guess it's just a milk run when you get used to it, huh, Lieutenant?
Oh, sure. All you have to do is to stay in this 20-mile corridor, hold exactly 170 miles an hour, maintain exactly 6,000 feet, fly instruments continuously, keeping a 3-minute interval, making radio checks on the second, maintain... Go ahead, Templehawk. This is 7223. Roger. You say there's an unidentified aircraft at 5 o'clock. Can you see it?
Yeah. Here he comes. Looks like he's towing a sleeve target.
Roger, Tevelov. Yeah, we see it. Rescue fighter towing a sleeve target. Just sitting on our wing.
You have another unidentified aircraft following you. He'll probably go by you in a minute or so.
Oh, you were 59 seconds late, boy, and he didn't go by. He went through.
How close?
I don't know, but he picked up 2 sacks of our coal. Templehawk? Freiberger, before landing checklist.
Heater switches off.
Off.
Picture takeoff and climb.
Take off and climb.
Main tanks on.
On.
Bypass valve down.
Down. Booster pumps on high. Put this field in a nice place, didn't they? Sergeant.
stuff.
With about only 200 feet and a quarter of a mile, I guess you could use GCA over those apartment houses.
Use it like money from home.
German?
Mostly, some DPs.
Who do you think is shoving?
Bitter, bitter.
Don't give me bitter, bitter. Stay away from me.
Come on. What do you want to do, start another war?
Hey, I think I'll check you.
Okay, I'll look you up next trip.
Oh, I'm asleep. Just leave your card.
So long.
Thanks for the lift, Lieutenant. Which way's operations?
It's over there.
So long. So long, Lieutenant.
Take it easy, Kowalski.
Pardon me, sir.
Yes, Sergeant.
Is it all right if I leave the field for a while? I'd like to take a look and see what Berlin looks like.
Not allowed, Sergeant.
You know how long we'll be here? 20 minutes.
20 minutes?
And you gotta stay right by the plane.
Four hours ago, it was so nice and clean.
Well, if this thing keeps going, wait till you see it 4 months from now.
Oh, brother.
An engineer for each cylinder. Now, here it is. Hey, where you guys been? You're 5 months late.
We wanted to see if you guys could do it alone, but you had to call the Navy.
Anchors away, my boys. Anchors away.
Okay, fellas, let's give it to them. Take it over, then. Come on.
One, two, three.
Off we go in the wild blue.
Runway.
I hear it's a bowling alley with lights.
Heater switches off.
Off.
Booster pumps high.
High.
Fingers crossed.
Crossed.
Gal flaps trail.
Trail.
That's a graveyard down there.
They sure make it convenient for you.
Bull flaps.
Hey, look, they got the honor guard out. Wonder what's up.
Probably some VIP from the Pentagon. Today, many people are gathered here to celebrate a milestone. The history of this truly amazing air operation.
Only a moment ago, when plane number 37 touched down on the north runway, it brought the total of airlift flights to the city to 100,000. To express their profound gratitude, representatives of the people of Berlin are present to present gifts to the crew of number 37. The honor guard of the Office of Military Government is also present, and in a moment, but now the lieutenant appears to be ready to give his first command.
Shindig's over with.
Hey, who are those guys? They're sharp. I wonder what this is all about, anyway. Hey, I want to get a picture of this.
Land your plane, sir.
Why? What's up?
Stop at this plane.
How do you like that? Can't even have any coffee.
Hey, what gives?
The honor guard is approaching plane number 37 to escort the crew to the microphones here beside me where the brief ceremony will be held.
I wonder where they're going now.
They're
going
to spell out Navy.
Must be some brass someplace. Nobody this way.
Nope.
Nobody this way either.
Fellas, I got a feeling this is us.
Oh, it can't be. It must be a mistake.
You boys are elected for something. Don't bother. You look simply lovely.
Fix your hat. I feel just as if you and I were getting married, Lieutenant.
And always, you are flying to us. In every kind of weather. In rain, in sunshine, and in fog. And so, I'm giving to you, Captain, this case, a thanks to you from men of Berlin's West Sector.
I accept this, not for myself, but for all those connected with Operation Biddle. Not just the Americans, the French, and the British, too.
Thanks.
And now, Helmut Brauker, 10 years old, representing the children of Berlin, will make his presentation to co-pilot Lieutenant Alfred Freiberger of St. Petersburg, Florida.
Now, Helmut, there's not one little old thing to be afraid of. Go on, say your speech just like I told you. Go on now. Go on.
The boys and girls of Berlin present this to you. And wanna thank you very, very much for everything y'all have done.
Well, Captain Stewart said what I was going to say, so I'll just say Dr. Shane.
Good boy, good boy. Have a chocolate bar.
Now to the flight engineer, Technical Sergeant Daniel McCullough from St. Paul, Minnesota, the presentation will be made by Frau Frederica Burkhardt.
Entschuldigen Sie bitte, dass ich so im letzten Augenblick komme, aber ich habe Frau Becker getroffen und die Räte immer so viel. Danke. Sergeant McCullough, I offer you this simple gift from all the women of Berlin, from the wives and mothers and from those who are alone. We have watched your planes bring to this unfortunate city not only food and coal, but serums and medicines without which hundreds would have perished. We have watched your planes take out sick and undernourished children and return them healthy and well-fed and happy. Now, this action tasche may appear to you to be empty, but believe me, it's filled with a gratitude and admiration of hundreds of thousands of women.
Take it. Oh, yeah.
Give him a cash, will you?
Yeah, Mark and Mr. Coulson. 99. Mark and Mr. Gross, a grateful Coulson.
All right, I will.
Hang on, Sarge. You'll get a draw. That's it, Sarge.
Well, that was fun. Now, will you all move over there? We want to get your sticks together, huh? Get right over there with her.
Perhaps you will meet again sometime.
They won't let us into Berlin.
What, not even for a little while?
Well, maybe if I'm very lucky, my plane catches on fire. Yeah, they might give me a couple hours. I'm lucky like that. Did I get to see you?
I'd be very happy.
Phone?
I haven't got a phone, but I give you the number of the person that lives next to me. It's 754532.
Roger. You know, I might even set that plane on fire myself.
Okay, that's it, fellas. The boys have to get back to work.
Hey, can I get a picture of him where he's kissing the girl, huh?
Peter Sean.
Sean? Yeah. Peter Sean.
Sergeant McCullough. McCullough.
I'm Dick O'Malley, Associated Press. I hear you're from St. Paul.
Yeah.
Well, the St. Paul Dispatch is one of our member papers. They've been after me to do one of those hometown boy flies lift stories.
I don't usually work with this box, but both of our photographers are sick. Would you mind helping me out with some pictures and answering some questions?
I don't know. I've read some of those pale blue yonder stories. I'd feel pretty silly.
No, this has got a different angle.
Well, thanks. I appreciate it.
Look, tell you what I want to do. I want to follow you and a load of flour from Rhine, Maine, into Berlin, through the warehouses, with the flour winding up as a loaf of bread in some kid's arms.
I see. You mean I'd have to come to Berlin, hmm?
For a day or two, it wouldn't take more than a couple of hours' work, though.
You know, sir, that kind of story hasn't ever been done before. It's funny, my mother writes to me, and she says a lot of people ask her, what happens to the food after Danny delivers it?
That after I deliver it.
Well, how do I know? I've never been outside Tempelhof.
Well, you'll do it then.
You can't get me into Berlin.
I'll talk to headquarters. You know, the Air Force doesn't mind a little publicity now and then.
They don't. I didn't know that. That's very interesting indeed.
Fine, I'll pick you up in Rhine, Maine in a couple of days.
Good deal.
Right, oh, thanks.
To set a record, you goof off. Well, I'll probably be working 18 hours today, and all the time you'll be in Berlin with some beautiful Shotzi.
Shotzi? Very colorful expression. You Air Force men are certainly interesting to listen to.
Now, quit the clowning and sit down here. The least you can do is take this trip.
No, I couldn't. I'd be too nervous. I'd push all the wrong buttons. Tell me, Sergeant,
Do you find this life exciting?
And fascinating, just fascinating. The last time I had this much fun, I was in a Jap prison camp and lost 79 pounds.
What were you doing, playing poker with English money?
Lieutenant, some joke.
Aren't they amusing, Mr. O'Malley?
Yeah, and fascinating, just fascinating. But
what I want to know is how you men fly at night. How do you do it when it's so dark outside?
Well, you see, there's a light out on this wingtip, and there's one out there, and there's one on the tail. So all I do is keep the plane between the three lights.
Well, I should have asked that question.
How long you been flying the lift, Sarge?
Since the first week in July. We all came over together. 19th Troop Carrier from Honolulu. We're part of the 53rd now.
How do you like your job?
Oh, it's a wonderful opportunity, and I'm grateful for it. You really learn your job on this operation. It gives you the feeling of accomplishing something.
You're now approaching the building area on a heading of 270.
We're coming in GCA. Listen to it. A friend of mine, best in the business.
You are now over building area, going high on glide path. Adjust your rate of descent. Glide path improving. Quarter mile from touchdown. On course on the glide path. Approaching the end of runway. On course on the glide path. Now start breaking your glide. Take over visually now and complete your landing.
That I gotta see.
Well, this is the whole setup. You understand the principle of GCA?
I wouldn't want to bet on it.
Well, without getting too technical, it works something like this. See, the antennas on top of the shack send out radio signals which hit an object and are reflected back here and show up on these scopes.
Like an echo.
Only a little faster, Junior. They go out and come back with the speed of light.
Like a fast echo.
Now, this scope is a 360-degree scan, and it revolves with the antenna on the roof, you see? Now, these spots that you see here, we call them permanent echoes, those stationary spots. Well, they're houses and buildings and chimneys and so forth. Now, the ones that are moving with the tails on them, you see them there?
No, where?
Right there. There's one. There's another one.
Mm-hmm.
Well, those are planes coming in and going out. Now, this scope isn't critical enough to land a plane, so we have these two, see? Now, here's the approach. That's the beginning of the runway. And over here, that's the glide path. Now, any deviation in the normal descent is shown up in this meter right here.
Where?
Well, if you look through the glass, you can see it. Now, he's bringing one in now. You see him? He's 50 feet too high.
Mm-hmm.
Well, now, this is the course scope, which shows whether you're too far to the left or the right. And here is the lateral approach, which shows the end of the runway. See that scratch there?
Yeah.
Well, we just keep steering them in to the right down the middle. Come on outside. I want to show you something. Now watch. It'll be right over the graveyard. Can you hear him in there?
Just level up momentarily. 1 mile from touchdown now, over the building area. Right on center line, right on glide path. Looking very nice. Approaching the end of the runway now. Right on center line, right on glide path. Now start breaking your glide. You're now in a clear takeover visually and complete your landing. QS wider tower for taxi instruction. This is Jigsaw.
Well, I'll be a... How do you like that?
Now, let me see. Turn a little bit toward me. That's fine. Not into the camera. Right here. Now, look pleasant. Look pleasant. Right. That's fine. Good. Well, I guess that does it, Sarge.
Moment, honey. Top end was for you.
Nylon?
Wrong side. You smoke? Cough, you'll stunt your growth.
Here we are.
Here, dear.
Okay.
Bit dead.
Well, thanks a lot, Sergeant. When I get the story done, I'm going to send you a copy.
Thanks for getting me into Berlin. I promise I'll do my best to promote better feeling between Americans and Germans tonight. Well, guten Tag.
Danke.
Well, you're welcome, honey. Auf Wiedersehen. Thanks again.
Oh, so long.
So long. See you, Sergeant.
Auf Wiedersehen. Yeah, yeah. Yeah. So now you know how they bake bread in Germany. A mess sergeant could have told you in 2 minutes.
I didn't want a date with a mess sergeant. Where can I telephone?
There's one down the corner.
Good. You know someplace I could take her for dinner?
Not around here. I know a spot where they don't bother you. Look, why don't I pick up my shotsy and we all have dinner?
You've got a shotsy?
Well, after 4 months, even I get tired of looking at nothing but blips on a radar scope. That little half pint works in a mobile snack bar.
I'm not sure you'd latch on to some American secretary up at Amgus.
No, with them, it's perhaps I can see you on Thursday. How do I know I want to see her on Thursday? With Gertie, it's different. If I want to see her, I see her. If I feel like talking, she talks, and if I don't feel like it, she keeps her mouth shut. Anyway, she gives me one day service on my laundry. PX takes a week.
Got a coin?
Well, bring it over here. If I wanted in the middle of the street, I'd ask for it there. Come on.
Not at home. She is working where was Barbarossa Strasse 26.
Well, that's right over by the field. You can drop me off.
Okay.
Wohin, bitte?
26 Barbarossa.
Bitte?
26 Barbarossa. It's over near the field.
Barbarossa Strasse 26. 26. No, 26. Neben München.
Ja, danke schön, ja.
Bitte, bitte. What's the matter? Don't you trust your German?
For me, they get only English. If they don't understand me the first time, I keep hollering at them until they do.
Where does that get you?
I learned my German the hard way, and while I'm around, that's the way they're going to learn English. Now, don't start feeling sorry for them. They hate our guts. If the situation was reversed, they'd kick your teeth in twice a day.
Wissen Sie, ich wollte Barbarossa 26 neben München.
Ja, das ist da drüben, ja.
Nein, nein, hier, wie kann es...
Ja, ja. Ja, ja. Dankeschön. Yeah, I did.
guten Tag.
Tag.
They gave me 24 hours. I've used up 5 of them already.
Oh, seeing me like this surprises you, I suppose.
Yes, it does. I guess I didn't picture you at such hard work.
Not always. I used to be a secretary for the head of a big laundry here in Berlin, but came the blockade and...
Oh, Burkhardt! Ich habe keine Zeit mehr für Gespräche.
Yeah, ich weiß.
You want me to go?
Oh, that's all right. You know, came the blockade. No lights, no laundry, no position, and nobody else needed a secretary. And in Berlin, when you are between 18 and 55, you must work.
Wouldn't they find something easier for you than this?
Maybe they could, but they didn't. It's hard, but we get the highest ration card, and that's very important here.
Say, I hope after all this you're free for dinner tonight.
Thank you, yes.
Frau Burkhardt, helfen Sie mal hier.
Yes, call me, ja schon.
Hey, how late do you work?
Oh, I'll be about 20 minutes.
All right.
But I've got to do some shopping on my way home.
That's okay, I'll wait.
Yeah? Good.
Stores, it seems like so little. Before you fly that stuff in, it seems like an awful lot.
It is. But almost 70% of what you bring is coal.
Yeah, I guess when you divide up what's left among 2.5 million people, it's not so much.
It's more than we expected. When the Russians blockaded Berlin, we all thought you would leave. There was an old saying, when the bear growls, the eagle will fly. And it happened. But you didn't fly out, you flew in. And we are grateful, very grateful.
You know what? You've got a British accent. Where did you get it?
My teacher in school studied in England.
Oh. Well, on you, it sounds good.
Thank you. Over there.
Bitte. Nehmen Sie.
Oh, danke.
Bitte.
Danke.
Haben Sie Licht?
Licht?
Haben Sie,
Ja, habe ich. Aber ich rauche erst nach der Mittagspause.
Wie?
Ja, nach Essen.
Ach, well, have one for yet.
Oh, danke.
Bitte schön.
danke. Ja. Haben Sie vielleicht für meinen Kumpel...
Ja, ja, also, Frau Wicker.
Ach, wunderbar.
Da!
And while you take a bath, I'll bring your uniform to the Schneider and he'll clean it and press it.
All this place for only 2 cigarettes. Oh, I got it on the bread, too.
Well, with our bread nowadays, it might even taste better like that.
Don't make me laugh.
I'll go down and get your uniform now. Here's Herr Stieber's bathrobe to put on.
Thank you, ma'am.
Guten Tag. Guten Tag.
Guten Tag.
Herein.
Hello. Sorry to bother you.
Was a dining room here?
Steven. My name's McCullough. I wanted to thank you for the robe. And Frau Burkhardt tells me that you heated the water for my bath. I sure thank you. Excuse me. What are you doing?
I'm a Russian spy.
You're what?
I'm a Russian spy. I count the planes that come to Tempelhof. Huh? Number of planes, time it comes, type of plane. Each 3 hours I talk to Russians.
Each 3 hours you talk to Russians?
Yeah.
Aren't you afraid I'll report you?
Americans know I do this. One time they fixed telephone for me.
You're the only one who does this?
No. Russians have like me at Tegel Airfield and at Gato, too.
But the official figures on airlift are printed in the paper every day. The Russians must see it.
Russians don't believe it.
Why? The figures are correct. The Air Force wants people to know.
You believe this. I believe this. But Russians don't believe it. Russians believe nothing they see, only what other Russians say. You know, here in Berlin, on the streets, we have... my English, that's, Wegweiser, you know. To this place, to that place.
Signpost.
Yeah, signpost, eh? This way to Andrew's barracks, that way to Andrew's. Russians don't believe it. They say no one could be such a dumb cop to show the way to General Clay's office room.
Tell me something.
Yeah.
You count the planes.
Yeah.
The other spies do the same thing.
Yeah.
Then your figures must agree with the figures in the paper.
No.
Why not?
Russians don't believe papers. And so I say sometimes less. That Russians believe made them very happy. Here in this house on third... Stockwerk, you know. And
Floor?
Yeah. On third floor there's living a man, Herr Malcher, and he spies on me. But Russians don't know that Malcher is the husband of my sister. And so Malcher says to Russians, Stieber's a very honest spy.
Who spies on Malcher? His uncle?
No, his nephew. Russians have 15,000 Germans as spies. They give us payoks, you know, that are parcels with fat, meat, sugar, sometimes clothes and cigarettes, Russian cigarettes. Bad. I would like to work for Americans.
Do they have many spies?
No, not so many. Only 10,000.
10,000?
That means 25,000 spies spying on each other. Things must get a little gemished.
Oh, yeah, a little sehr gemished.
Yeah.
But there's also maybe 500 who are spying for both sides. You must love. That's necessary. It's a very good thing for, no work.
Unemployment?
Yeah, that's a very good thing for unemployment. Oh, excuse me. American Airlines commercial.
Der Schneider ist nicht hier, er ist weggegangen.
Wo ist er denn hingegangen? Ich habe eine Uniform hier, die dringend gebraucht wird.
Seine Frau hat ihn angerufen. Ihr Sohn wurde von russischer Polizei verhaftet. Er ist gleich nach Hause gegangen.
Können Sie mir sagen, wo er wohnt? Ich muss unbedingt die Uniform haben.
In Charlottenburg, Ulmstraße 22.
Hat er Telefon?
Nee.
Ulmstraße 22? Hm? Danke.
Of all the Schneiders in Berlin, the Russians have got to pinch the son of the one that's got my pants. Well, I can always sit by a window and watch lift planes land at Tempelhof. What did they want him for, anyway?
Oh, I don't know.
Well, the Russians, who knows? Maybe he says something they didn't like. Maybe he is something they need in Russia, electric lightsman, or he can fix engines. Walks into Russian sector and, whoosh, auf Wiedersehen.
Say, maybe you could go to the tailor's house and bring him back here.
Yes, but for me, he might not come if you weren't an American soldier.
What am I going to wear?
Oh, no. No, sir. If I'm seen out of uniform, I've had it. They give me 10 days of goodbye stripes. Worse than that, they'll take away my PX card.
Yeah,
look, needles. We haven't seen those for a year.
I forgot my cigarettes.
Oh, we can get some down there.
I've only got script.
Oh, you can pay me later.
Haben Sie Zigaretten?
5 Stück, 2 Mark. He's got everything but bananas.
You want banana? 8 Marks.
9, 9, 9,
how can you go out with me?
Look at this.
I'd look like that, too, if it weren't for some friends in St. Louis. They send me these clothes. We're coming into the Russian sector.
Russian sector? I thought everybody stayed out of the Russian sector.
Just the military. The Germans go back and forth all day long. We just go through part of it here and then into the British sector.
Siskov in Bachnet. Ich rieche Kaffee. Welcher haben Kaffee? Aber es muss jemand haben Kaffee. Ich gehe jetzt durch den Wagen. Wenn ich komme zurück, will ich sehen Kaffee. Sonst werden alle durchsucht.
What's the matter with him?
He says somebody's got coffee and unless it's turned over his searchers. Haben Sie Kaffee bei sich?
Wochenlang habe ich ihn nach und nach zusammengespart, um in Kohlen einzutauschen.
She's been saving the coffee to trade it for coal.
Stecken Sie ihn doch unterm Hut. Unterm Hut sehen Sie nicht nach.
Gut, danke.
Also, wo ist jetzt Kaffee?
Steckt unter dem Hut da.
Sie können mir ihn doch nicht wegnehmen.
Ruhig, du kannst sein froh, dass ich dich nicht mitnehme.
Kinder! Er hat jetzt einen von Kaffee. Wenn er uns untersucht, dann hätte er 13 Pfund.
Denn ich habe zwölf. So, jetzt kriegt Tante Wutschen zwei, bitte. Macht immer noch ein Geschäft von einem Pfund, ich.
It is
22. Great, we got the wrong address.
They probably live in the basement.
Nun weiß ich nicht, wann er wieder nach Hause kommen will.
She says her husband went to a Russian sector to see whether he could find any trace of their son. And she doesn't know when he'll be back, and he's got the key for the store with him.
Well, I guess there's nothing we can do. Tell her we'll be back later.
Sagen Sie Ihrem Mann, dass wir später wiederkommen, ja?
Ja.
Auf Wiedersehen.
Wiedersehen.
What are we going to do? I'm supposed to meet my friend in half an hour.
We could go and have dinner and come back here afterwards.
Go like this?
Oh, they won't bother you.
Okay. How about that? Now the sun is shining. What's the address? Savrin.
I know where that is. Not far from here. We can take the trolley for a way, and then it's only a short walk.
Walk? Wait a second. Get the Savrin in your shoe. Spread it. No! Before things were like this in Germany, how long would it have taken till I could put my arm around
you? Oh, that would have depended on two things. Which part of Germany and which part of me? Like this, so close, month and month.
This blockade has its advantages.
And this was just filled with trees. Oh, it was such a beautiful park. And on Sundays, families used to walk along here and look at the statues.
Who are all these characters? Frederick the Great.
These are all the military heroes. It's called Siegesallee, Victory Avenue.
They don't look so Siegers anymore, do they?
What is it you say? They are hot?
Yeah, smooth, in the groove, hot. Now, how do you work this dootsie business?
Well, in German, the word for you is sie.
No,
and
but when you get to know somebody real well.
Well, you're familiar, du. It's like thee and thou, the same as on the streetcar. Usually this would take a long time.
But when you've only got 24 hours and you've used up 8 of them already.
For such emergencies, we have the dootsies. We link our arms and drink. And then we...
Is there any custom for doing this a second time so we can get more familiar?
I never heard of any.
Well, let's start one.
Guten Tag, Herr Kowalski.
Well, if it isn't Fritz. You sure went native in a hurry.
Well, that's my uniform with the tailor. Now I can't find the tailor.
You're the nicest looking piece of MP bait I've seen in a long time.
Rodriguez, this is Sergeant Kowalski, Frau Burkhardt.
How do you do?
Hiya.
Oh, where's your,
Gertie, she stopped to say hello to something. Here she comes now. There's a real mess for you, huh? But she irons a good shirt, so what she looks like, to sit down. Sit down, don't spoil her. This is Gertie.
Gerda.
Gertie's good enough. Sit down.
Frederica?
Good enough. I'm Gene.
Danny.
Hi.
Sit down. You people shake hands more and mean it less.
I believe this man over there is trying to attract your attention.
Guten Abend.
Guten Abend.
You speak English very well. Where did you learn?
Night school. She also speaks a little Russian and French. I noticed him when I came in. He looks familiar. What's his name?
Günter Lütke.
No, that doesn't ring a bell. Maybe he works around Tempelhof. Danny tells me your husband was killed in Russia.
Yes.
What was he, SS?
Do you want to dance?
No, and I don't mind answering. My husband was not in the SS. He was drafted.
Someday I'd like to meet just one German who enlisted.
Tell me, Sergeant, in America you have no conscription. Nobody was ever drafted. I heard 11 million.
And I read in a paper...
Who asked your opinion?
And now I suppose you want to know about my father and my mother. My mother was killed in an air raid, and my father went much earlier. He was a professor at the Berlin University. And when they burned the books, he spoke out against them violently. They burned his books, and I haven't seen him since. Now, is my record satisfactory, Sergeant?
Mind if she sits with us?
Look, I just asked a couple simple...
insulting questions.
And I got a couple of insulting answers, so we're even. I'm sorry, okay?
Okay.
Okay.
Your father must have been a very brave man to say those things at that time.
Not brave. He just believed very strongly.
My father believed, too. But the wrong things.
Your father was a louse. That's the big reason you people got sucked in by Hitler, this father business. I swear I know that guy from somewhere. From the time German kids are so high, Papa is the boss. He tells you what to say, when to shut up, what to do, what to think. Papa can be the biggest jerk in the world, but what Papa says goes. Then along comes another jerk like Hitler, and he becomes the Papa for all the Papas.
Yes, I've read about that father complex many a time. I doubt whether it's true, but if it is, you are certainly doing nothing to cure it.
What do you mean?
This stupid lug, you're treating Gerda exactly the same way. You tell her what to say, what to think.
You know something? You're right. When I'm wrong, I admit it. You're absolutely right. From now on, you can disagree with me.
Out loud?
Sure.
And you'll answer questions?
Of course.
Good. You know, I'm so mixed up. We found out in Germany what was wrong. But to find out what is right is not so easy. I read the Russian-German papers, the American-German papers, the German-German papers. Oh. I want to find out so much about America.
Shoot, ask me.
What is democracy?
Go ahead, Kowalski, tell her.
It's such a stupid question. What is democracy? Democracy is democracy.
Yeah? What is it?
And what is that?
Everybody get titles, please.
That is the police coming to check up. Let me be the first to call you Private McCullough.
If you haven't got any papers, you must get out of here.
I can't afford to bother chatting out choo-choo. I've got my fare. And got the five little fare. Julie, Beth, Pennsylvania Station, Baltimore, cause it's too far. Rain to make the scene, and you're in Baltimore. Sing in the diner, nothing could be finer than to have your ham and eggs in Carolina. When you hear the whistle blow and take to the bar, then you know the Tennessee is not very far.
Relax and never take a voice like that.
Oh, oh, Chattanooga, there you are. Sometimes you might have a big dog package you bought up. Here shops be like, it's with the cold and off ice. It's still up lots in these and dog package you bought up. Schatz ist mich schwer, wenn ich mich sehen kann, wie quer. Ja, schwer, 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 das ist doch halt heute gar kein Problem. Auf dem Puffer oder Tritt, da steht man mit Schwimm. Und ich drück kein Fußball, fährst du auf den Dach mit. Und rein kommst du doch so frische Luft.
You see?
Yeah, but what is it?
Oh, look, I've been trying to tell you. Democracy isn't a hunk of bread, something you can point to like that. Well, it's a lot of things, and most of them are up here.
Yeah.
It's kind of a feeling.
Yeah.
The way you look at things.
Yeah.
You understand?
No.
Oh, you're stupid. You're just plain stupid.
But I'm also German.
It's the same thing.
And if you can't tell me what it is, how do I know if I like it?
Take my word for it.
I took my father's word for it. You said that was wrong.
Oh, I was right. Don't take my word for it. Look, I'll explain it to you. But will you listen? Will you please use your head?
Was daraus wird, was sich ergibt, wer kann es wissen? Ich bin verwirrt, ich bin verwirrt, ich möchte dich küssen.
What's the name of that?
Vielleicht. Perhaps, maybe.
Maybe.
People.
Yeah.
It's a people's government.
Yeah, now we're getting someplace.
Then it's like Russia. That's a people's government, too.
Now we're not getting someplace.
But, Hank, you just told me that...
All right. Let's say Russia is a people's government. Yeah. But it's a kind of people's government where the leaders decide what's best for the people. With us, the people decide what's best for the people.
Oh, no, but this Russian soldier I knew, he told me that's not true. He said in America, a few wealthy men who own many newspapers decide everything. They tell the people what to say and what to think.
Wait a minute, Toots. Now, we had an election some time ago. 90% of the newspapers were against Truman, and the bookies were laying 50-1 he'd wind up back behind the shirt counter. So who's president? Truman. Nobody wanted him, but the people. Now, you ask your Rusky boyfriend when was the last time he was at the polls and saw anybody's name but Stalin.
Oh.
Ooh. Nothing. I just remember where I met that guy.
But Hank, but...
I'll be right back.
Felix! Sie verwechseln mich mit irgendjemandem. Mein Name ist Günther Lüttke. Hier sind meine Papiere.
You know, I kept looking at you in that restaurant. I knew I'd seen you somewhere. When you got up and limped, it all came back to me. You're the spitting image of a guy I knew over here during the war when I was in a prison camp. His name was Felix.
Sie irren sich. Ich heiße Günther Lüttke.
Take it easy. I just said you looked like him. Let me tell you about this guy. He had a bad knee, just like yours. He couldn't get in the regular army, so they made him a prison guard. He hated it. He wanted action.
Ich verstehe nicht Englisch.
Your eyes seem to understand English. That's enough. So this Felix started a private little war all his own. He hated the Americans. He hated the Poles, and I was both, so he picked on me. When we went out on work parties, he'd take me off in the woods and make me speak German. Not simple, easy things like Guten Tag and Auf Wiedersehen, but nice little tongue twisters like der Potsdamer Postkutscher, Potsdam, Potsdamer Postkutsch, Kasten. That's tough enough for a German, but for an American, well, I made mistakes. And when I did, he'd correct me with the butt end of his rifle, right here in the kidneys. It used to swell up like a hunk of dough with too much yeast in it. I got about 3 lessons a week. It took me about 7 months, but I learned German. Of course, I've forgotten some of it, but if the weather changes suddenly or I bend too quick, you'd be surprised how quick it comes back to me. It's a tough way to learn a language, but there was nothing I could do about it. I was a prisoner. I couldn't take a swing at him. Come to think of it, you're sort of in the same spot now. You're a German civilian. If you got a beef with a soldier, you couldn't lift a finger, could you? Trying to get to the Russian sector so I couldn't follow you. You know, Felix, I could squeeze until you were as cold and white as a statue, but it would be too easy. I'm going to give you an English lesson, Felix. And I won't need a gun, but... Now, the Germans have a hard time with their W's, don't they? Well, I'm going to give you something easy to start with, not too tough. Just say it after me. Which way went the winged whippoorwill? Now, mind, I don't want to hear any V's in there. I'll have to correct you. Now, try it. Which way went the winged whippoorwill?
Which way?
No! No, Felix. Which way? Try it again.
Which way?
Once more, Felix, which way? Which way?
Hilfe! 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 Hilfe!
Holen die Polizei! Da hinten wird ein Mann ermordet!
Wo denn?
Ein Soldat mit dem Täter und
Suche! Das ist doch schon wo?
Da hinten, in der Siegesallee!
Are you crazy or killing? Hey! Let's get it! The MPs are coming! Turn them loose!
Jeep, they're making for the gate.
Stopped. What are they stopping for?
Oh, they wouldn't come in here. This is the Russian sector.
Oh, great.
Oh, no, there's nothing to worry about. We just go down...
You mean going into... No, let's just wait here. And then we'll walk back.
Into that jeep again? No, the best way is just a few blocks from here where the three sectors come together. We can cross over there.
Well, what about Hank?
Oh, he'll be all right. It will be his word against Günther's, and they'll decide the Germans started it. And Gerda will be there. She'll lie if necessary. Cigarettes and soap are not easy to get.
Oh, why didn't I bring my identity card? No identity. Do I look Russian to you?
No.
We lost him.
This way. No, this way.
They
want to take us and we're on the British sector.
She's quite right, you know. They are on our side. Where do you live?
Templehof, American sector.
You?
He's my husband. He was shot in the throat during the war. He can't speak.
What's the matter? These Ruskies giving you trouble?
Oh, same old thing, mate. Border quarrel.
Looks to me like they're way over on your side. Used to be a line here someplace.
No, can't make anything of it, though. It's been trodden out.
Let's get this business settled once and for all. Let's call the major.
Yeah, and I'll ring the duty officer. Right now, don't let him get these people away from you.
No.
You mean they haven't been back here at all?
No, and they haven't called on the telephone, too.
Oh, it's all right. We're friends of theirs. Where's our room? We'll wait.
Right here. Oh.
A trunk fell on my hand. Will you heat me some water so I can soak it?
Oh, yeah.
Turn on the lamp, will you? I don't suppose anybody around here's got a drink. Here. Go make some coffee.
Yes. Oh, but I don't know these people to use up their gas.
Give them some cigarettes.
You don't feel better?
No.
Your hand hurts more?
It's not my hand. For 7 years, I've been waiting for the satisfaction of beating that face in. So now I've done it, so why do I feel this way so dirty?
It's better than feeling good.
Go make the coffee, will you?
boundary is 14 meters from that curbstone.
Stones, cousin.
What are they saying?
Well, the colonel states that the boundary is not 14 meters from this cornerstone, but from that one.
Let's measure from over there.
Fair enough.
What are we waiting for?
Here's some fresh coffee. May I ask the Umrats to have some?
Sure, why not?
Well, Felix knew if he said anything, I'd mention his phony papers, and...
I'm sorry.
When they asked who started it, we both said you did.
That was nice.
I figured you'd get away.
Yeah, sure.
What about the tailor?
Can't work at night, no lights. I'm gonna pick it up first thing in the morning.
You can't stay at the base looking like that.
I could go to my sister's. You could have mine.
No, thanks. It's been arranged. I'm gonna stay here. Frederica's gonna stay with the lady across the hall.
Herr Stieber, Flugzeug kommen!
Missed it. So I missed it. That one was only American propaganda.
Futter ist am kein Sand und das Klavier kein Pedal. Und Krachel, so heißt dort der Sekt. Im Grand Hotel ist es mondäner. Doch dort ist es tausendmal schöner. Kleinen Café in Hernals spielt Grammophon mit leisem Ton in Englisch Waltz. Dort genügen zwei Mokkalein, ein paar Stunden so glücklich zu sein. In einem kleinen Café in Hernals klopft manches Herz so hinauf bis zum Hals. Und geben zwar Verliebte sich dort's Rendezvous, drückt der Herr Ober ganz diskret ein Auge zu.
Hank, don't you think you ought to get over to the hospital and have somebody look at that hand right away?
That's all right. Stieber here tells me he was an actor in the States for 5 years.
That's so.
Yeah, and the student prince. I traveled all over America. Big cities, little cities.
But you must tell me about that.
11:30, I didn't know it was L.A.
So I won't get so much sleep. I don't mind. She wants to learn. That's good.
Tell me, what did you like best about America?
The way the Americans don't like it.
What?
I mean what they used to say against the government. Oh, on the radio, in hotels, trains, barbershops. Oh! Ah, guten Abend, Frau Kirchner.
Hi, Barbara Stieber. Guten Abend. Wollen Sie
sich nicht ein bisschen setzen?
Oh, lassen Sie mal, ich bin zu müde. Gute Nacht.
Oh, I get it. Come on, knucklehead.
Good night.
Take some advice from a guy whose batting average is pretty good in this league. Don't wait for the floater to cross the plate. Swing it.
What was that you said?
I was just telling him how to get to first base.
First base? What's that?
Well, it's a... Look, it's tough enough explaining democracy to you crowds. Let's not start on baseball.
I'm sorry, Danny.
That's all right.
Well, I don't know how you stand that noise. Every 3 minutes, I go nuts.
When you know it means coal and food, you don't mind. It's only the silence on foggy nights that keeps us awake.
The wind shifted. They're taking off this way now. We're doing better than one every 3 minutes.
A little after three.
Three? What are you earning at this hour for?
Today we've got electricity from 3 to 5.
Well, that's a pleasant time. Who figured that one out?
All the big power plants are in the Russian sector. There's only one here, and that isn't big enough to supply all the districts in the western sectors at once. So they divide it up.
Is it my shirt? You shouldn't have done that.
I hope it's all right. It's so long since I ironed a shirt.
Fear and loneliness. You must have had more than your share of both of them.
When you look at me like that, I feel secure and no fear. I want to draw closer, not away. Danny, I think you love me just a little.
More than a little. More than just a little.
Ach, yeah. And the Russians say you are...
Lice, gangsters, rats.
Yeah, they say that too, but what is it when you don't do what you say other people should do?
Hypocrites.
Yeah, yeah, you're hypocrites. You fought Hitler because he was against the Jews.
Oh, and wait a minute. That's only one of the reasons.
Yeah, but still, you hated him for it. And the Russians say in America, Jews are kept out of certain hotels and schools.
And they're right. It shouldn't be. It stinks.
Uh-huh.
But where did you find out about it?
I read it in a book.
An American book?
Yeah.
Where'd you get it?
From a friend.
Where'd the soldier get it?
In the PX.
Well, look, stupid, that's your answer. Here's a book that points out something pretty awful about America.
Uh-huh.
But it's written by an American, printed in America. It's a bestseller in America and sent here by the American government to be sold in the PXs.
Yeah?
Yeah, yeah. Look, the next time you're in the Russian sector, do me a favor, will you?
Uh-huh.
Get me a copy of an anti-Russian book written by a Russian living in Russia, printed in Russia, and sent here by the Russian government. Do that and I'll give you a month's salary. You get the point?
Now I know. In America, it is not wrong to be wrong if you say it's wrong.
What do you got stuck on your shoulders? A cantaloupe? I didn't say that. I know, but I...
Like the new look?
Just adorable, especially the midriff.
It's cold.
Well, at least you're still a sergeant. I thought maybe they shrunk you to a corporal.
I think they cleaned it with reducing pills. You did a nice job of pressing, though, don't you think?
Which one are you going out of?
107 right here.
How'd it go, Esther?
Very interesting.
Interesting? What'd you do, go to the library?
Yeah, we read Schopenhauer together till 6 in the morning.
Hey, Mac, what happened to you?
They sent me to the cleaners. It's amazing how much you can go through and still want to keep on living.
Yeah, I guess it hasn't been easy on them.
I never realized. Just staying alive could be a 24-hour job.
And I suppose you wanted to know all about America?
No, she didn't. She knows. She has friends who write to her from St. Louis.
Look, why don't you come, too? She's a smart dame. She pays you fast. You're a nice, sweet, intelligent, understanding schmo. So with you, she's using the slow sympathy routine. I guarantee you, with me, just like that.
Why don't you stop jumping to conclusions? Or at least use them where they fit. They don't happen to fit here. Look, she's had it, so have a lot of other people in this town. But She didn't want to talk about it. I made her tell me.
Yeah, I know. You just have to drag it out of these poor people. I feel so sorry for them. Every Sunday at 4 o'clock, I come here and bleed. You know, there are some things they just can't stand to talk about, like Rotterdam and Warsaw and Coventry and Lidice and Belsen and Dachau and Buchenwald. Did she talk to you about these things? No! This is something that happened 10,000 years ago. That the Germans never heard of. That they can't remember. But they didn't get meat last week. This they remember, and this they feed to suckers like you.
Oh. What am I supposed to do? Blame all that on a girl who was, what, 15 at the time?
I've been trying to tell you ever since I...
Think this is big enough to bite that?
Now, it hurry. You better bite two and sew them together.
Don't you have any with perfume on them?
Say, lady, could you model these for me, please?
I'll take the white one. Until this afternoon, you get off about 1,300.
Okay, okay. You can go to town to see her, but keep checking the weather.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
You sure took off in a hurry. By the time I get in from the shack, you were gone.
You going to town?
No, I just wanted to talk to you.
I got to talk to somebody else.
That's what I want to talk to you about.
What about
I've been
it?
Delivering your cigarettes and blouses and stockings and coffee. I just wanted to see you get your money's worth. So far, you haven't been. Maybe you better look at this.
What? What is this?
A little further down, you'll see that that husband of hers was in the SS. In the early days, those boys weren't drafted.
Where'd you get this?
I figured her for a phony right from the start. A friend of mine in the document center looked up the file on her. On the next page, you'll find out that wonderful father of hers never saw a university. Had a little dough, wanted to keep it, so he played ball with the boys. Walked out in her mother in 39 because she happened to be Polish. Nice guy.
It's true. All of it. There are many other things I lied to you about that are not on that paper.
Why?
What? What I told you is maybe what I wish had happened.
What your husband did and what your father did, that wasn't your fault. But why did you lie to me about them?
Perhaps to make you more sympathetic. When you have to live by the generosity of others, you learn to make yourself pitiful and brave. When you live in a sewer, you soon discover that the sewer rat is best equipped to survive. Well, look around you, then. That's why we lie. To escape from it for even a moment now and then.
Thank you.
We've been here longer than 6 months already. How do you like that? I've been home 3 weeks and didn't know it.
Morning.
Good morning, sir.
Excuse me, sir.
What can I do for you, Sergeant?
I'd like to apply for permission to marry a German civilian, sir.
I've discovered, Sergeant, that all such applications made at 8:30 in the morning are always canceled a few days later. Why don't you wait till about 5 this afternoon?
Oh, it's not like that, sir. I was on duty last night.
Oh. Well, I guess I can dispense with the talk I give the kids. I guess you're old enough to know your own mind. Ask the sergeant. He'll give you the necessary papers, and I'll go over the case as soon as you fill them out. But you must remember, Sergeant, that if and when I give my permission, the marriage cannot take place until 30 days before your departure.
I understand that, sir. I noticed by the paper this morning rotation is starting. Is there any indication of when my number might come up?
That's all pretty new. But I wouldn't count on anything for less than 60 days.
Thank you, sir.
Ground grippers have sure got it tough. I don't know how you stand it.
Just grit your teeth. You get used to it. Want a cup of coffee?
No, I can't. I gotta get back. They're trying to make the turnaround in 14 minutes. Will you take this? Give it to Frederica. The paper she's got to fill out.
Sucker, why don't
look,
you...
the only permission I need is from my squadron commander, not from you.
Will you deliver it?
If it clears up, I will. If not, I'll give it to Gertie.
In America, if you want to go from one place to another, you don't have to have permission from the authorities?
No, all you need is a train fare. Just pack a bag and go.
Unwahrscheinlich. But in Europe, it is not so easy to work together like that.
You Krauts wouldn't try to give the world a hot foot every 25 years, it might be. Oh,
look, even just in Western Europe, we have so many different people, different languages, different customs. Well, it would be impossible.
What do you mean, impossible?
All right, suppose you take an island. And aren't you put Germans and French, huh?
Mm-hmm.
And English and Irish and Jews
okay,
and
okay.
Poles
okay, you don't
and
have
Italian.
To take a cook's tour. I get the idea. What are you trying to say?
Well, what would happen with all these people on the same island? In 5 minutes, they'd kill each other.
When they made Snow White, they should have got you for dopey. Ever hear of a place called Manhattan?
Manhattan,
yeah. Yeah, it's an island, part of New York City,
oh,
just
yeah,
like
yeah.
you're talking
yeah.
about. 12 miles long and 3 miles wide. And you know what we got in New York? We got more Irish than they have in Dublin, more Jews than there are in Palestine, more Germans than you got in Dusseldorf, and more Italians than they have in Naples, plus a 500,000 Poles besides the Swedes, the Greeks, and the French. They all get along all right. No, I'm not saying they love each other, but they've learned to live together.
This is true?
No, no. We built New York just for propaganda. Nobody lives there. It's inhabited by... Hey, Stieber!
Ah. Guten
Tag, Herr Stieber. Guten Tag,
Herr Garner. Hi. Will you give this to Frederica? It's from Danny.
Yes, that's certainly.
Okay.
Wiedersehen. Was kostet das? Hans, was für mich dabei?
Nein, nur für Frau Burkhardt.
Danny, Sergeant Kowalski hat ihn mir eben gegeben und der kam eben mit der Post.
Und
next week.
Hey, they just posted the stateside list for next week.
Come on, let's move. We all want to take a look. Hey, Danny.
All
I see they got you on for Friday. Hey, let me go.
Come in. I am holding.
Sorry to bother you, sir. I just found out I'm due to go home on Friday.
So I see. Placement's coming through faster than we thought.
Yes, sir, but what about my marriage application?
I'm trying to get Berlin now to see what we can do about it. Hello! Is Major Bolt there? Major Bolt!
I can't hear you! Speak louder!
Major Bolt! Baker! Abel! Love! Tear! Yes, Bolt!
These long-distance calls are murder. I think the German telephone system is made out of chicken wire. I hope we can speed up your application.
Perhaps I could go home a couple of weeks later.
Oh, no, Sergeant. That would mean 50 forms in triplicate and cost the government at least 30,000... Hello! Major Bolt? This is Major Hetzel.
Who?
Major Hetzel at Rhine, Maine.
You'll have to speak louder. I can't hear you. Yes, louder. Love, oboe, uncle, dog, easy, Roger.
Okay. Now, here's the dope, Sergeant. Instead of sending your papers through the regular channels, they'll give them to your pilot on your next trip up. He will bring them to me. I will sign them in the 18 places and give them to you.
I certainly thank you, sir. But what about that month before departure regulation?
This is classified as extraordinary conditions. Circular 3, paragraph D, subsection 12. You can marry her any time before your departure time Friday.
But she lives in Berlin, sir.
I know. Get one of the off-duty engineers to ride up with you, and he can work the trip back.
Yes, thank you very, very much.
Okay. But I wish you guys would stay single.
Will be very grateful. The ones he's got are so bad.
Honey, you're talking to the guy that wore them. Well, 48 hours and we won't have to worry anymore about red tape.
What did you say?
I said...
Shut up!
48 hours and we won't have any more worries about red tape. I'm coming! I guess I gotta go. Here, Doc.
Thank you.
Bye, dear. I'll see you soon. Bye.
What a word for idiot.
Pilot.
Sir. Let me see if I can work it out.
Well, here comes one of our pigeons home.
And it looks like he's gonna roost for a few days.
Afraid not, Sergeant. It says here stateside departures will be on schedule. You will leave by train tomorrow for Bremerhaven and home by boat.
Thank you, sir.
53rd Troop Carrier Squadron, Major Hetzel speaking. Yes, sir, Colonel. Right away, sir. And we hope it will lift enough here for takeoff starting at 1,200 hours, with Temple off partially and intermittently open starting at 1,400 hours. It is important to land every ton we can, but your lives are more important. You will make your GCA approach,
And when you have let down to your minimums, if you do not have sufficient visibility, pull up and come back. Taxi conditions at takeoff position here are not good. Proceed cautiously. Here is your time hack.
Okay, in 20 seconds, it will be 11:15.
What am I doing here? Today's my day off. I ought to have my head examined.
What that follow me jeep needs is another follow me jeep to follow.
Tower just cleared 6-8. Tower, this is 3-7. Our interval's up. What are you waiting for, the sun?
Tower to 3-7. Keep your shirt on. How's your visibility?
Can't complain. How's yours?
Look, wise guy, how far can you see?
Well, I can see up in the tower.
What's more, you need a shave.
Okay, it's your neck. You are clear, pardon the expression, to take off.
3-7, roger. Bye-bye. Get in that 6 misses in a row.
Well, maybe we'll be lucky. 5-5 got in.
Too thick, I guess, huh?
We're down to minimums. Can you see anything?
Just my wife and 2 kids.
I don't want to be a hero. We're going home. Flaps up to 20.
Tower 3-7, fail a breakthrough. Returning Ryan Main. Over.
20.
Roger, Big Easy 3-7 from Temple off tower. Cleared to 6,500 feet. Cruise 170. Regional 3009. Remain on this frequency and give check call over 1C. Over.
Gear up. Sorry, Mag.
It's a beaut.
Feathering 4. Pull the firewall shut-off valve. Cut mixture on 4. Gas off. Trail number 4. Pull the fire bottle. Switch off. Generator off. Booster off.
How did we look back there? About the same, sir. Maybe a little worse.
Do any good?
It's good, Al.
Better give him a call.
Temple off tower, this is Big Easy 3-7. Number 4 is on fire. We can't get it out. Request emergency landing instructions. Over.
Well, you don't have to look so happy about it.
Roger, Big Easy 3-7 from tower QSY to frequency 14058 to approach control for emergency clearance. Over. Emergency, do not acknowledge. Big Easy 3-7 with number 4 engine on fire will get emergency landing on runway 27 left and to the west. Stand by.
Big Easy 3-7. We have you identified. There's nothing between you and the slot. Crash crew standing by. Now steer left 180 degrees, bringing you on crosswind leg. Start descent to 1,500 feet QSY to jigsaw 140.58.
Jigsaw 3-7 coming in on emergency landing. Do you have him?
Roger. Big Easy 3-7, this is Jigsaw. How do you read? Over.
Roger, Jigsaw. 3-7 reading you 5x5. Over.
Roger, 3-7. Understand 5x5. Make final cockpit check. Gear in the green. Now turn to a heading of 270. This is your final approach. Maintain altitude of 1200 until further advised. 5 miles from touchdown on course. Do not acknowledge any further transmissions for the remainder of this run. Drifting slightly left, steer right to 273. You're approaching on course perfectly. Steer left to 271. Your new heading, 271. You're on course approaching glide path. Lose altitude at 750 feet per minute. You're on course heading 271. Touchdown on course, going 50 feet low on glide path. Approaching building area. Adjust your rate of descent. You're now 60 feet low. Still 60 feet low. Adjust your rate of descent, please. That's better. Glide path improving now. Steer right 271, 3/4 mile from touchdown. Adjust your rate of descent, please. That's it. 1/4 mile from touchdown, approaching end of runway.
We haven't got time for this kind of thing.
But tell me, how...
No, no, quiet, quiet. Just listen. We got to move fast. I got to get to the consulate right away and get some papers stamped. But look, you got to go home, get dressed, and meet me as soon as you can at the Temple of Burgermeister. Hank and Gerda will be there. They're our witnesses. Now, where's your stuff?
There.
Get your coat on. We got to be witnesses at a funeral. Max marrying that dame. Don't just stand there. Come on, look alive. Get moving.
I don't feel like going.
I don't feel like going. Look, I don't care what you feel like. Get your coat on.
You treat me just like my father did. Get your coat on. Do this, do that. Keep quiet. Sit down. Stand up. I'm tired of it, and I'm not going to stand for it anymore.
What's the matter? Are you plastered or something? What have you been drinking?
Words. Good words. I've been reading this. Your Constitution. The Bill of Rights. What Lincoln said and Wilson and Roosevelt.
Well, don't let it go to your head.
And after what I read, I see something now. You are a disgrace to America, and they shouldn't send people like you here.
Now, enough is enough. Who do you think you're talking to?
It doesn't matter.
Well,
I can say what I want. Article 1 says, Congress shall make no law respecting an establishment of religion or prohibiting the free exercise thereof, or abridging the freedom of speech or of the press, or the right of the people peaceably to assemble and to petition the government for a redress of grievances. That's what it says, you big, stupid jackass.
One more crack like that, and so help me, I'll knock you from here to Potsdam.
All right, go ahead. Hit me, stormtrooper!
No, wait a minute. You're not yelling at some crummy crouch, you know. I'm the guy that brings you the cigarettes and the candy and the soap and the stockings and the coffee.
I'm sick of you and your coffee. Get out of here, I'll have you thrown out.
Why, you...
And I got the perfect right to. Article 3 says, no soldier shall in time of peace be quartered in any house without the consent of the owner, nor in time of war, but in a manner to be prescribed by law. Now get out and stay out and don't come because of...
Baby, now you got it. That's what I've been trying to tell you. Don't let anybody push you around, not even me. That's democracy. Now you got it.
You can take your cigarettes and your candy.
That's it, baby. Keep pitching. Hit the bullseye and you get your first paper. Yes, come on. You're a citizen, honey.
Take your spam and your spam.
Gerda, please put your coat on, baby. We'll be late.
Ja?
Ach, Frau Bogarecki, gleich zur Post. Kann ich was für Sie mitnehmen?
Das muss Gedankenübertragung sein. Ich habe gerade geschrieben und wollte auch gehen.
Dann geben Sie mir doch mit. Flankieren auf dem Postamt, das Geld können Sie mir ja später wiedergeben.
Wunderbar. Schönen Dank.
Nicht zu danken.
Wiederschauen.
Sure, now that I will be with you again someday, you must write quickly and tell me how long I must stay with him before I can get a divorce and not have them be able to send me from America. In a way, it will be worse being in the United States, so close to you, wanting to be in your arms, and still so far away. Perhaps you could come to St. Paul sometime and would meet in a theater or a store every so often.
Papers to fill out. Fine.
You have to wait. The Burgermeister's hitching somebody else.
Oh. You know, whether you had time to buy a ring. I brought this. It was handed down to me from my grandmother.
It's beautiful. Where did you get it?
My grandmother.
Oh, yeah.
Danny, I'm so happy. But also a little sad that you are going back to America tomorrow.
Yes.
When will I come? In a month?
I think it will be longer than that.
Oh, no, Danny, no.
I'm afraid so.
Where will you go, St. Paul?
Maybe St. Paul. I might go to St. Louis.
Why St. Louis?
Why not? It's a nice place to live, don't you imagine?
Give it to me.
No.
What is this, St. Paul, St. Louis?
You get your wish and find a way to get out of Germany.
And I hope you don't. We can do without you, too.
afraid your grandmother handed you down a lot besides that wedding ring. Gerda. Where are you going?
Oh, I've got to find Danny. I can't let him go like this. He mustn't judge people by a person, good or bad. For what she did, there is no excuse. But to know how she could do it, he must look back. When we grew up, only lies were taught, and to tell the truth was to disappear. Only the end was important, they told us. How we reached the end made no difference. Cruelty was everywhere, and to betray your friends was not bad. Feelings of others meant nothing. And, oh, Hank, I've got to talk to him. For some, there has not been time enough yet to unlearn these things.
Gerda.
And for some...
Gerda! You're going back to your place. I'll see you later. Mac, come on, let's grab this taxi.
Oh, Gerda.
Bye.
Bye, Danny.
See you sometime.
No, I don't think so. I stay here. I want to see one day the right kind of journey. Maybe I can't help much, but I want to see it. And if everybody who wants something different and better looks for it someplace else, what happens here? No, I'll stay. Goodbye, Dad.
Goodbye.
Hey, there's one up. Looks like you'll get away.
Yeah. How about you?
I forgot to tell you I switched to permanent duty. Well, they got some new GCA equipment coming in. They want me to help get the case out of it, that's all. Why don't you watch what you're doing?
Trillions, bitte. Stup mir sehr leid.
Ist schon gut. Aber seien Sie mal vorsichtiger. Wohin Sie sich der Bürste schieben?
Jawohl, Herr Schatz.
Well, I suppose if we're ever going to sell these stoops a new way of living, you got to be a pretty good salesman. Anyway, it won't kill me to try it for a while.
Hiya, Mac. Going back with us?
Yeah. I seem to remember us standing like this once before, shouting advice at me. Guess you were right.
No, we were both wrong. You were too easy, and like Gerda says, I was acting like a stormtrooper. I suppose the answer lies somewhere between us. Say, if we never made mistakes, we'd be second lieutenants.
Well, see you, Hank.
Goodbye, Danny.
Hey, hey, come here, will you?
What do you want, meathead?
What is Kraus yelling about?
Die Russen haben die Blockade aufgehoben. Willi hat das über dem Radio gehört.
He says somebody heard over the radio the Russians are going to lift the blockade.
Yeah, yeah, danke.
What are you thanking us for?
Say, you think this thing is really over?
When they start putting the seats back in these things, then I'll believe it. Well, I don't know. If they can take off when the birds won't even fly, I guess a blockade isn't much of a weapon.